Welcome everybody to this course, which is Organizational Behavior and Leadership. And this is the chapter number one. The book is available for all of you. A free PDF from OpenStax is a marvelous resource that you can have and read every single chapter in every single week so you can be more successful. Remember that this is, again, chapter one, Management and Organizational Behavior. And why we study this is part of your program, right? But also because we need to understand how the people behave, the decisions they take, the how they manage the different kind of activities, because you know what? You will be dealing with people as administrators in all your life, in every single activity you do. It's important to understand the behavior of your community, your customers, etc. So we consider this is important, and also remember that work is something very important to think about, because work is about your personal purpose, about your purpose of life. So if you think about work, it's about the activities that you perform in order to develop and help your community. I know there is an economical reason for work, but also there is altruistic reason, and this is a long topic, but it's something about that. So if somebody feels that is not attached, or is not engaged, or is not identified with the work or with the activity that we are doing, that's what we call alienation. Alienation means that you're supposed to be engaged with certain kind of activity, but you are, like I told you before, separated from the activity. That's what alienation means. Also, remember that the workplace will be changing all the time, taking in consideration the new technologies, taking in consideration the environmental changes, taking in consideration the world changes. Like, you know, we all doing this course virtually. Right now, the classroom is empty because that world is changing. So this is something you have to be aware. International competition, what that means. We spoke about some countries or some regions have something we call competitiveness, industrial competitiveness. What that means? That means that this country is, or this region, have a particular reason why this product they produce is better than others, or is more in a competitive advantage, right? We also spoke about, for example, some countries have been competitive advantage in different kind of activities. If you think about China with the labor, you know, human labor, they have a industrial competitiveness. But if you think about India, for example, it's another country. If you look at the statistics, it's have been increasing the product per capita. So this is also related with their industrial competitiveness in some areas. If you think about here in the States, you can see there's several professionals from India in technology. So this is another example, a simple example about how industrial competitiveness can be a very important way to get away of the general and go to be special in the market. That's all we want. So that's why also we use technology as a resource for helping our production. If you think about Japan, for example, it's a country that has been special, let's put it this way, in the technology area. In my case, you know, I come from Dominican Republic, so if I can present you something that Dominican Island have industrial competitiveness, is about tourism. They have been special or highlighted in tourism because the industrial competitiveness. So think about that. Industrial competitiveness means something that make you very special in a different area that put you in the top of the market, okay? And this is another concept that you have in your assignment too. diverse workplace. And this is, you don't have problem with that because we are in diverse environment here and I enjoy it so much, people from different countries. And also with that being said, different countries, different idea, different concepts, help the company to have a different perspective and help the company also to be successful, right? So that's why we are looking at business, and you as a manager, you as organizational behavior, you know, with your organizational behavior knowledge and your leadership, you will be aware of that multicultural environment, which is so important in your organizations, okay? The book mentioned something that I don't want to speak a lot about because I don't want that you block your mind with the structure that the society have. But as you know, most of the women have been, you know, treat different because the condition, or some races, particular kind of races, have been, separated for some reason. So I don't wanna take time about that.